Hi everyone, welcome to today's tutorial, and in this video I will be showing you how you can recreate this milk box packaging template, and it's fairly easy to do, and let's see how that's done. So as you can see that I've already created this template, and I will be using the making a similar template as well. So the first thing I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna go ahead and open a new document. So I'll go to File, click on New. Okay, so I will be using this A4 size document, which is 210 mm by 297 mm. The orientation is going to be portrait, and I will be renaming my document to be milk carton. Yeah, and go ahead, click on save. Okay, so when we open up a new document, so by default this layer 1 also comes up. I'm gonna go ahead and rename my layer 1 to be template. Okay, I'm gonna zoom out so that I can see what all that I'm designing or creating, right? So to zoom out, you click on Control and the minus key on your keyboard, like that. So, and also make sure that my smart guide has been switched on. So I go to the views panel right here and make sure that my smart guides right here has been activated. So the smart guides will actually help us a lot in making our packaging for this milk carton. Okay, so let's start. So I'll be making these flaps first. So this document right here, this is going to be the front side of our packaging. And these two smaller rectangles are going to be the sides of our carton. And as you can see, this document here, which has a nutritional pack, this is going to be the backside of our packaging carton, right? And over here on the top and at the bottom are the flaps. So let me just briefly tell you. So where you see all these lines right here, where all these triangles are being made, right? So these lines will be actually be used for the folds, and folds are supposed to happen. And this rectangle over here, it's for your hand, so that you can hold the carton a lot better. And right over here, this rectangle as well. This is going to be the place where glue is applied and it's stuck from the inside of the carton. So this is going to be the inside flap, whereas all the other flaps you see on the top and the bottom, that's going to be the outside flaps as well. So only some of the flaps as well, when it's folded, it will be folded from the inside. Alright, so I've briefly just told you about this, and let's begin. I'll be using the rectangle tool again, and I'll be making a smaller size rectangle like this, and I'm gonna go ahead and also just place it on the side like that. Yeah, then I'm gonna use the rectangle tool again. This time I'm going to make the back side of the packaging template, so it's going to be the same size that of my front cover, right? So I'll just click on my document, and I'm going to give the same dimension as that of my first document. The width, as far as I recall, the width was 210 mm, and the height was 297 mm, and I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. I'll just make sure that it's that of the same size, and yes, it is. I'm just gonna go ahead and drag it over here like that. I'm gonna copy this image onto that side as well. So I'll just click on all and drag it over here. Notice that how the smart guides are telling me where the center point is and where I have to intersect. That's why I was telling you that it's important that we get our smart guides activated like that. Okay, so we've got the front, back and the sides of our template as well. Then I'm going to go ahead and make these flaps. So what I'm going to do now is that I'll be using the rectangle tool again, and I'm going to go ahead and make rectangles like these. I'm going to copy them as well. Copy this one as well. Excuse me. Sorry about that. Okay, so you've got the upper flaps. So I'm going to go ahead and also make these triangles on these two flaps as well. To do that, I will be using the pen tool and I'll remove the fill temporarily. I'm just going to go ahead and make these triangles like this. I'm going to select this triangle and bring it over here onto the other rectangle as well, and make sure that it aligns with the top of our document like that. Yep. So now, what I have to do is that I will be creating this portion right here. So I'll select this, I'm going to zoom in on this. And what I'm going to do is that I'll be using this add anchor point tool from this pen tool command. I'm just going to go ahead and make three anchor points like that, and I'll be using the direct selection tool and selecting these three anchor points by clicking on shift. So this one anchor point right here, click on shift, select these three anchor points like that, and I'll be using the shift and the arrow keys to bump it a little upwards like that. I'm just going to go ahead and select these two anchor points. I'm just going to round the edges off a little bit like that. Okay, so we've got this. And now I have to make this smaller rectangle as well. So you guessed me right, I'll be using the rectangle tool again. And I'm just going to go ahead and make one small rectangle like this. And temporarily, I'm just going to fill it with black so that it gives an illusion that this is the where it's going, it has to be cut so that your fingers can hold the handle. And I'm just going to zoom out again, and yeah, you've got this. Now what I'm going to do is that I'll select these three rectangles right here, and I'm going to make a mirror image of it onto the other side like over here. Right, so what I'm going to do, I'll select this, click on shift and select my shape. I'll right click on this, on these shapes, and I'll see this transform option. I'll now go to this reflect tool and I'll click on this horizontal axis and I'll click on copy. As you can see that a mirror image has been made. I'm just going to go ahead and just drop it right here, and I'm just going to bump this one upwards like that. I'm going to make slight changes so that I know that it's well adjusted as well. Yeah, I've got this. Now I have to make these two flaps as well. So what I'm going to do is that I'll be selecting this, and by clicking on Alt, I'm going to make another copy right about here. So I'll select this and this, and I'm just going to make another copy by clicking on Alt and dragging my mouse like that. Okay, so you've got this. Yeah, I'll select these two, and I'll come back here to this direct selection tool, and I'm just going to select these anchor points by clicking on to shift till I see these smaller circles, which is right in front of my anchor point. I'm just going to go ahead and round the edges off like that. So we've got this. I'm going to come back here to this rectangle tool and carefully make a smaller rectangle like that. I'm going to select this, click on Alt, and bring it over here as well. Notice how the smart guides are indicating where I have to intersect. Right, so we've got this. I'm going to select these two. I'm just going to make them a little bit more bigger by dragging it like this. Okay. So I just need to adjust this a little bit. Okay. I'm going to zoom in on this just to make sure that it's properly placed like that. Okay. So we've got this. Now I have to make this big rectangle where the glue will be applied to be stuck on the inner side of the carton. Right, so I'm gonna go back to my rectangle tool and go ahead and make one simple rectangle like that. Now I'll be using the direct selection tool, I'll select this anchor point and click on shift and the down arrow key to bring it inwards like this, that creates a certain slant like that. We've got this, and now I just have to make these certain lines which indicates where all the folds are going to happen. So that's really, really easy to do. So I'll be using the line tool again, and I do not require the fill, so I'll be clicking on this none option so that only the stroke is left. So this is the line where my triangle is ending. I'm just going to go ahead and make a straight line like that. I'll select my line and I'm going to go ahead and make copies out of it. So I'm just going to do Ctrl C for copy and Ctrl V for paste. And by using the shift and the arrow keys, I'm just going to bring it right over here like this, and I'm going to make another copy by clicking on Alt and like that. Okay, so we've got this, and now I'm going to make another line which goes at the bottom from the tip of my triangle like over here, and one straight line like that. Yeah, and another line on the same way over here as well, and we've got this. Okay, so now that we've got a basic template, I'm gonna go ahead and also add certain colors to our template as well. I'm going to just select these triangles first, like this. I'm going to go ahead and add a slightly gray shade to this. So what I'm going to do now is that I'll select these triangles sorry, these rectangles, and also fill it up with a slightly lighter shade of gray like that. Once I've got this, I'm just going to select everything and add the same shade of light gray. Oops. I'm going to carefully select the flaps I want the light color to, light gray color to be there. And like that. Like this. I'm gonna select this one which has the fill. I'm gonna click on Alt and then just drag it right over here as well. Okay, so now we've got our basic template. So now the only thing I'm gonna do is now I'll select everything and I'm going to increase the stroke weight. So by default it was 1. I'm just gonna go ahead and make it 3 points. So that it's easier for you all to see where the lines have to be folded and creased in order to make a cartoon, right? So once that's done, I'm going to go ahead and also lock my layer so that when I add any of these graphics now onto my cartoon, I do not accidentally remove anything or delete anything from my template, right? So I'm going to go ahead and create a new layer. And in this layer 2 panel, I'm going to name this layer to be, let's say, graphics. Okay. So now I'll be adding this vector image of a face of a cow. Right? So I've already had these photos saved. You can get these images easily up on Google if you just type in the PNG format or the vector format. I'm going to click on Ctrl plus O and there it is, my face of my cow. I'm just going to select this image and drag it onto my template right here. Now since the image size is really small, I'm going to go ahead and also scale it up a little bit more. So I'm going to click on Shift plus Alt and drag my image like that. So it fits into my cartoon box right here. I'm going to select this, click on Alt and bring it over here as well. So over here at the back side, it's going to have a smaller image at the back. So this image of a cow acts like the logo as well. Drag it like that. Okay. I'm going to select these two images and I'll temporarily unlock my layer because I do not want the white background to be seen. I want my image to be blended with the color, with the background color as well. So in order to do that, I'll be going to the transparency panel and over here in the blending mode, I'll be clicking on multiply. So if you do that, notice that the white background now gets removed and it gets blended with the background color as well. I'm going to go ahead and also lock my layer again. I'm going to select these two for now. I'm going to add a drop shadow behind these images to give it a more 3D effect. So I'll go to effect panel right here. Come down here to the stylize option and click on drop shadow. So by default you can see that the opacity is 75%. And I'm just going to bring the opacity down a little bit to 55%. And I'll let the X offset and the Y offset and the blur to be the way it is. And the color is supposed to be black only. So if I click on OK, notice that this drop shadow comes up, but it's not looking too great. So I'm just going to click on Ctrl plus Z. Like that. I'm just going to let it be the way it is right now. Okay. We've got that. So now I'm going to go ahead and add the rest of the images as well, such as the barcode and the nutritional values as well. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Ctrl plus O. And I'll first add the barcode. And I'm just going to drag my image over here at the back on one of the flaps right here, like that. Close this image. And now I'm going to open up a new image which says the nutritional value of milk, unsaturated milk actually. I've got this, and I'm just going to drag it right over here. So again, I will be have to scale this image. So I'll click on Shift plus All and drag my image like that so that it becomes bigger. I'm going to go ahead and zoom in on this. Bring the image, like just adjust it a little bit like that. I'm going to go ahead, select these two images again. Make sure that I temporarily unlock my layer. Come back here to this transparency panel. In the blending mode, again, I'll be choosing multiply. Okay. So the reason why I'm locking my layer in order to blend, because if you do not unlock your layer to apply this blending mode, it's not going to happen because my template is locked. So this blending mode is only going to be applicable if it's unlocked, right? I've got this. Okay. I'm going to make it a little simpler version of the milk carton. I'm not going to add this red image right here, this graphic. Like that. I'm going to keep it simple and minimalistic. So I've got this. Now I'm going to go ahead and also lock my layer, graphics layer. I'm going to create a new layer. And I'll rename layer 3 to be text, because usually if you've seen any food or beverage items, they do have certain texts as well, such as the name, the manufacturing date, the expiry date, and if anything, any additional information such as like store it in a cool place, etc. Right? So once that's done, I'll click on my type tool right here. Click on my document. I'm going to rename this to, I'm just going to name it milk for now. I'll go ahead and also increase the size of my text. I'm going to keep it here. So I'm just going to rename this as well. I'm just going to rename this to Dairy Freshness. And I'm going to go ahead and bring it over here to the middle like that. Probably just bring it a little down like that. Okay. So now I'm going to copy this now, this text, click on all and bring it right here. And now I'm just going to type out 100% unsaturated cow's milk. And I'm going to bring the font size a little bit more smaller to 36, like that. I'm going to select this text and bring this over here on the side as well. Probably just place it over here. I'm going to zoom in on the text and I'm going to write and then I'm going to write a note saying consume of, I'll just write the expiry date actually. Let's just give it a random date such as 30th June 2020. I'm going to select this and I'm going to go ahead and also make this bold. Like that. Get this a little up. So click on Alt and bring it down again. This time I'm just going to change this to batch number. Just give a random number, let's say 112, like that. And now that we've got this, I'm just going to add one more icon to this. I'm going to go ahead and open and I'll just type in recycle icon, which means that after the milk is consumed, then the carton can be recycled in different ways as well. So when you open up this image, I'm going to just crop this a little bit because I do not require this excess white space. I click on crop image. Drag it over here. I'm going to resize this as well, make it a little bit more smaller, like that. And it looks pretty neat. I'm going to go ahead, unlock my template layer, select my icon, go to the transparency panel, and in the blending mode, I'll be choosing multiply again. Okay, we've got everything. So now what I'm going to do is that once it's made, I'm going to go ahead and also save my documents now. So in order to do that, I'll be going to File and clicking on Save As. So by default, my file name is going to be the same as my document name, which was the milk carton packaging. And my Save As type is going to be Adobe Illustrator. I highly recommend that you save a file in this format so that in case if I want to make any further changes, I can easily do that by accessing my AI file and click on Save and click on OK. So there you go. Our document has now been successfully been saved as an AI file. So you'll know that this .ai comes in front of your document, which means it's now a legit AI file. So thank you for watching and stay tuned for more. Thank you.